What's up, guys? Tim Little. Welcome back to Tactical Bassin. Today, got some products that I've been playing around with. You guys know that Matt and I, we are tackle junkies, right? We're always buying stuff. We're always trying new baits. So I got six or seven new products that I've been trying and had some success with and want to share with you guys. You know, it's kind of a hodgepodge of stuff. Got some swim baits, some crank baits, some finesse baits, some hard baits. So kind of a mixture of everything. Right off the bat, let's talk some swim baits. You know, for years, Matt and I, we've had so much success and so much, caught so many good fish on the Keitech 2.8. There are several new small swim baits on the market, and I wanted to share with you guys a couple of them that I've been playing around with and really like. You know, we're always preaching you guys to be a little bit different, and as these small swim baits go, they have different actions, and so if everybody's throwing a Keitech 2.8, you want to throw something a little bit different. So I started playing around with these two, the Damiki Armor Shad and the Megabass, the Hazedong. Now they come in a couple different sizes. These are the 3-inch, both of them. And what I've found, this Megabass right here has a real tight, real quick kick, whereas like a Keitech is more of a big thumping, wide thump, and the Armor Shad is somewhere in the middle. So if you guys are throwing the Damiki rig, or you're throwing a little 1/8 ounce swim bait head, maybe a Matt Allen swimbait head, a little 1/8 ounce, and you're throwing just a straight 2.8 to 3-inch small swim bait, definitely give these a try. You know, the 2.8 is a killer bait. Like I said, we've caught a lot of fish on it, have a lot of confidence in it, but these are two other baits that I've been playing around with and catching fish on. They come in a bunch of cool colors. Let's talk deep cranking. So, you guys that like throwing 10XDs, 20 plus foot deep diving crankbaits, I've been playing around with this guy right here. This is actually the Dredger 22.5. It is made by Berkley. And as you can see, it's a fairly small crankbait compared to the other crankbaits in that depth range, that 20 to 25. You're talking 10XDs, you're talking about the Big Lucky Craft. But this is a normal size. It's a little bit longer, maybe, I don't know, 2.5 inches, but a really small body type, really, it's not a giant bait at all. And this thing is getting down to that 20 to 26 foot range. I actually have it paired with a 12 pound fluoro on here. But the one thing I noticed about this is it gets down quickly. It's not as buoyant as some of the bigger baits. There's less material, so it doesn't float up as fast. It gets down quicker. But the coolest thing about this bait, what really intrigued me about this bait, was the overall size. You know, when you're getting those big baits down there, yes, you're reaching a depth that those fish haven't seen that action. Yes, it's a bigger presentation, but if you want to present a smaller presentation, a bait that they don't have as much trouble getting in their mouths, I think this is gonna be a winner, guys. It's, like I said, it's a normal size deep diving crankbait, kind of like a DD22 or a DT16 maybe. But that right there, that is the Dredger. And I've got it down about 20 to 22 feet. On the package it says up to 26, but maybe that's long line and trolling or I don't know. But it still is a great bait to get down at those depths where a lot of crankbaits don't reach, and you don't have to fight the bait as much. You guys know the 10XD, I mean, that thing pulls hard. It's a workout if you're fishing that all day. And that's what's nice about this, is it doesn't pull nearly as hard. It's got a pretty tight action, and it's getting down to those deep depths. Right along that cranking setup, guys, this is the new IMX Pro. This is the 906 CBR. It's got a real soft tip, real moderate action. And I've been throwing this bait on it, and it's awesome, guys. It's fairly light, very sensitive, and it's just really comfortable to throw. I paired that up with the Kronark, the 150. You guys know that I love that reel. I was a little worried that throwing the big D deep crankbaits on this reel be overpower for it, but this little guy, the smaller bait, works fine. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it for the 10XD or any of the bigger baits, the harder pulling baits, but it works great with this guy. Super super comfortable. But getting back to this rod, it's a 7.6, moderate fast action. And so far I've tried 3 or 4 models in this new IMX Pro line. And all the models that I've purchased, I've been super happy with. Cheaper price point than the higher end Luma stuff, the GLX and the NRX. Still, you know, good price for a great rod. I'll leave it at that. A couple other baits real quick. We'll go some finesse real quick. This is the Reaction Innovations Shiver Shot. Matt's been preaching to me for a long time about this bait. You know, he guides, he's on the lake 6-7 days a week. I don't get to fish as much as he does, but this is quickly becoming one of my favorite drop shot baits. And he was raving about it as a bed bait. Got a cool little action. It's got that kind of shaddy bait fish, bluegill kind of profile. So that is another winner by Reaction Innovations. They have so many great soft plastics. And the last bait that I want to talk about, I don't know that Matt and I have even ever done a tail spin video. But this is the new, this is the Axe Blade by Damiki. This is a 3/4 ounce bait. What they've done, they've went and they've actually tied in a little double hook on the back. So where do tail spins shine? They really shine for me in suspended fish. If you want to match the hatch and fish the correct depth that the fish are sitting in, cast out, count it down, and just retrieve it back just like a spinnerbait. That blade on the back's gonna thump, flash, and they're gonna eat it. You can also do long pulls, not like popping a jig or how we talk to you about hopping the lipless cranks. It's gonna be like a lift up 6 or 7 feet and just let it fall on semi-slack line, and that thing's just gonna kind of flutter down and flutter up, flutter down. But they added the double hook on the back. Where that shines is short strikes. A lot of fish on spinner baits, tail spins, they hit the blade. That's the flash, that's the moving part, right? So they hit that, so they put a hook back there. So leave this keeper on there. Don't take the keeper out of the package. Don't take it off. Fairly good hook up front, but here fishing on Clear Lake, I do switch it out to a bigger hook. You guys can play around with that. But tail spins, that is a sleeper. A lot of people don't talk about it. It's a great cold weather bait, cold water bait. When fish are real lethargic and they're downs deep, you can vertically fish it. If they're offshore fishing or chasing shad balls, you could bomb this right through it and let it flutter down kind of like a spoon. That is a winner by Damiki. Just like every video, guys, down below in the video description, we'll link to you guys every product we talk about. We'll list some of the colors that we like. If you guys have any questions, leave those down below. I think that's it, guys. You know, Matt and I, we're always buying stuff, and anytime we start catching fish on certain products or things that we really like or fall in love with, we want to share with you guys. So there are some new swim baits for you guys to try out. There are some new drop shot baits or shaky head baits you guys can try out, and some cranking and reaction baits, guys. So if you guys have any questions, like I said, down below, leave them in the comment section. Matt and I will try and get to those. If you guys have any recommendations for videos, let us know also down below. Guys, we appreciate your support. Have a good day.